Hi, it's Shari from Little Blue Deer, and I'm actually back today with a new tutorial. I've been working a lot on my designs, and I'm ready to start accepting new clients again. So I do feminine custom WordPress blog design, and would love to help you out. But I also understand that there are so many good page builders out there, and people like to DIY things. So today, I'm going to show you how to make this cool wave divider pattern right here in Elementor. So what we're going to do is go to, and this assumes that you have Elementor Pro. You can get it. I think it's about $59 a year and a very nice and fun creative page builder. So we're going to go to the page that we want to add this shape divider to and click on Edit with Elementor. And that's going to load the back end of our Elementor page builder. And I've already put this widget together, but I'm going to show you exactly how I did it. So it's really quite simple. And I'm going to scroll down to this section. This is actually two sections. So Elementor has these sections. So the first thing I did was just add a section. And if you want to add a section, you can just go click on this plus mark, and then you can add your flex box or grid, whichever type of section you want to add. I'm actually not going to do that because we don't need a new section. But all I did was add a section, and then I added an image, which you can do by simply going to image and clicking and dragging your image. Once again, I've already added the image. And then I did the exact same thing down below with another section and another image. So what I've done to create this wave pattern is I simply went to the container and I set a background color for the container here. I chose background type classic, and then I set the color. And then I did the exact same thing with this container. Once again, style, background type, and I went to the color. And now how did I get this cool wave divider? So for the top section, I went to the edit container and I went to style and I put shape divider. I didn't want it at the top. I wanted it at the bottom. You can choose either. And I chose for this one, the waves. So there's a bunch of different ones. I picked waves, and then you can see it defaults to white, but you can set your color here. And this is where you can control the width. So as you can see on the right side of my screen, the width is going up and down. And we can sort of adjust that as we want to. And that looks kind of cool. But what I really like is being able to add this sort of stripey border across. So we also want to do the same thing with our second container, except in this container, what we want to do is go to the shape divider, and we want to go to the top section. So once again, I've chosen waves. I don't need to set my color because I want it to be white. It's going to default to white. And then I've got my width, so I can sort of adjust the curve if I want it to be super to match perfectly. I like it a little bit off center, and I really like how it offsets with these images. And then I can scroll down a little bit further here. You can see I can set the height. Now what I did to reflect it, so if I don't have it flipped, it doesn't match evenly with the top section. So to make this wave that matches, I flipped it. You also can see about how you can invert it, which kind of gives you a bulging shape. I don't really like that as much. So we're just going to stick to the flip. And then that's really all there is to it. So you could do this for as many containers as you want, but it kind of allows you to have, without having to upload an image, a nice shape divider between two containers. And when I go to publish, we'll be able to see. I just think it looks kind of cool. I think you could put a lot of different types of sections in this. I just think it's a nice looking divider and just sort of a cool visual accent. if you will. So when I exit out of my page, you can see I've got this slider up here, and then I'll scroll down and here I've got a couple of cool little images and a shape divider. And you can see the divider here, and it's very easy to do. So that's my short tutorial on using the Elementor shape divider. And if you would like to have a custom blog designed by me, then I would definitely be happy to do this for you. And thanks for watching.